Oh. Thank you. it.
To say hello. Hello, hello, hello. Thank you. And happy to see all Manjushri family. And myself, very happy to come back home. And now, I don't know what should I talk about. I must be nervous now. The Buddhist attitude of the human life, you know. Kind of, you know, more, you know, positive and more advanced than animal life. We should understand that our life is, you know, more advanced, more distinguished, highly, you know, sort of advanced and distinguished from the animal life. All kind of animal, you think about, you know, some animal is we consider very intelligent, like what is it, whales, the fish, you know, there are many animals, you know, who are very intelligent and good communication. we consider it in the world. However, Buddhist attitude, no matter what animal is, you know, intelligent or happy or, you know, free or in the jungle or whatever, you know, but human being is the most, you know, perfect one and the most intelligent one, and we can do it. Such, you know, profound, you know, action which the animal cannot do. That's why, Buddhism, we consider that the human quality is, you know, so developed, you know, maybe the scientists said that from the, you know, monkey, you know, the evolution of human being. Similar Buddhism, we have the intelligent, you know, the conscious, evolution of the existence of human being. So this is so highly developed. Normally we think, you know, we are incapable to make happy oneself, isn't it? And to make happy other people. But the wrong attitude, Buddhist point of view, we can make ourselves happy, we can make other people happy. We can do. This is the human, you know, power, you know, human potentiality. Concerning human, all the existent evolution, you know, we call the karmic causation. We need, you know, developed many, you know, good quality in order to become human being. So that's why we say human, the life is the most precious thing. So one should be utilized as much as possible, you know, profound way. Or by recognizing the profound, you know, the potentiality and the profound achievement of human, goal. We have to, you know, understand. Now, if we don't understand those realities, then we don't have enthusiasm, we don't have motivation to act, you know, because we can't see. Now, Buddhism is talk about truth, you know, in the Western religion, we also talk about truth, isn't it? Buddhist point of view, truth is existent, you know, with us all the time. Truth is nothing changed, you know. Absolute quality truth is nothing changed. Relative quality changing, but, you know, one have to understand changing is the nature. Nothing impossible things happen. It is, you know, character. It's one, you know, phenomenon. So one have to be, you know, accepted. The changing is the nature. Buddhism, we have concept of karma. The karma is the changing process is the karma. You know, changing process of life and the, you know, thinking process, you know, of thinking process. The, you know, changing thinking, thinking process of, and life is the karma. So, we do have, you know, kind of authority of freedom to change, you know, our, you know, lifestyle. As you have Western, you have, you know, different lifestyle and different, you know, all philosophy and different religion, different way of thinking. This is the, you know, actually the human, you know, dignity, human knowledge and human quality. One have to understand how the human being, how the changing, flexibility and directing such human life energy, you know, a different way. This opportunity, this freedom we have now. This freedom is the knowledge of, you know, the human being. Advantage of human being. Of course, human being, we do have problems. We do have negative quality. We do have positive quality. We do. But this quality of negativity or positive is you know, conventional. Confusion, momentary. Today you have problem, tomorrow it disappears, that problem. Isn't it? Last month you are miserable situation, relating human relationship or anything. And this month is, you know, disappear, that problem. So the problem, you know, coming, going, is, you know, conviction. We do have problem, you know, but this problem, what we have, you know, up and down, is not the, you know, essential, you know, the human dignity. It's a kind of, you know, like, you know, ocean wave, you know, turbulent, you know, surface turbulent, isn't it? You know, but not shaking entire ocean, isn't it? The similar. We do have, you know, every day up and down problem. It is like, you know, ocean wave. But the fundamental, the nucleus of human being is not still not shaking. The fundamental truth of human being, human quality, is still there, without shaking. But relativity, you know, the manifestation of ego, is the, you know, sort of making, you know, dancing and the nightclub and the, you know, sort of manifest. It is still temporal, still temporal. As you know, since we brought up to now, so many relativity trips, what we did is, you know, confusion. But still remain such a, you know, deep fundamental, you know, truth is always there. Which is not marked by the negativity, you know, or sin or what do you call, you know. So they are the different. They are different. Thank you. Now, the reason why I'm telling you, the Buddhist attitude that my human life, the most precious thing, the comparatively, you know, any mixture in the world, not possible to compare it to my own life, you know, uncompared to entire English wealthy. So now question is, how to utilize You see, what is the purpose you want of human life? From this point of view, the human being is capable to achieve happiness and peace, great joy. The everlasting, you know, joy. The everlasting, you know, peace. Can call it peaceful. That you may be itching. You know. Everybody has that, you know, the potential, you know. All the potential to achieve that goal. So we should put energy that direction. Not, you know, sort of caught. Situation where there is, you know, a concentration camp. You know? And if you think of the concentration camp, you know, Hegla, you know, if you think that concentration camp which Hegla put you is fantastic, you know, that is enough for you, you know. That's all your achievement, human life, happiness. Then you wrong thing, wrong thing. Since we born up to now, we put in so much energy entire our life to just receiving, you know, temporary, transitory pleasure. You know, we put in so much effort. Yeah? The result is like concentration pleasure, you know, concentration camp pleasure, you know. You cannot say, you know, Hegla concentration camp has no pleasure. There is pleasure. When they get food or, you know, when they get something, there is some pleasure. You know. The same thing, normal life, we do have pleasure. You understand? We do have pleasure. Whether do we believe it? Human being has pleasure, but we compare it. It's like modern, you know, life, modern, you know, our society, we compare it, isn't it? Say, this good enough? No, we need this one. You know what I mean? This good enough? No, we need this one. You understand? The similar, we have exactly, you know, this attitude, isn't it? You look at entire, you know, pleasure, you know, from the bottom pleasure, middle pleasure, peak pleasure. We look at, you understand? That's important, yes. Just look at the entire pleasure. To look at is, you know, type or entire, you know, total picture of pleasure of human being, achievement. or you can achieve. You have to look at totality. What is the attitude? You have to look at totality. But then you work out. You should not be stupid. Just enjoy, only chocolate, enjoyment. You do know that the enjoyment of chocolate is, not sufficient. That's why it is so logical that material pleasure is so limited pleasure. And one of us own entire English money or wealthy. One of us from here, okay? Okay, one people own entire English wealth. Still do you satisfy? This is so logical, isn't it? Who satisfies? One have to make clear, no. Not only English wealth, entire universal space, everything is you own. One person you own. You still you satisfy? You are not satisfied. There's no question about it. Buddhist point of view, there's no question. No satisfaction. Then maybe you can say, in my home, I'm satisfied. What you monk talk about, I don't care entire English wealthy I have or not, in my home, I'm satisfied. Then I'm going to say, you truly satisfied? You could say, no, that's right. Didn't you agree with me? Yes. It is so logical. Because the characteristic of ego, as long as you have ego mind, you have certain particular desire to achieve certain thing. So you struggle, isn't it? You struggle some way, you want something not getting for you. That is the suffering. That is the suffering. Which you don't want one coming, which you don't want. In your life, that is coming forcefully. These two reasons is you dissatisfied because manifestation of ego. I don't want you understood from me that the human being have no enjoyment, no pleasure. But, as our modern society, you should have, understand, that you need, some kind of reasonable, perfect, professional pleasure. Not enough, the grasping or the worldly pleasure, which is the momentary, all pleasure, but the resource of more confusion and more dissatisfaction. Well, of course, I mean, that also attitude. Lest I say, why don't you say I am satisfied? Why don't you say I am satisfied? I'd like to know. Just curiosity, you know. Well, you think about it. You think about it. Why don't you satisfy? Why don't you say I'm satisfied? No. True self. You know, truthfully yourself. I'm not saying fantasy, I'm satisfied. Of course we say I'm satisfied because I'm you know? You understand? You know? I'm not talking about this kind of, you know, sentimentalist, you know, satisfied, you know. I talk about you just sit down, you know, truly look at your life, you know. I'm satisfied. What do you say? Oh. Actually, you know, isn't it? You know why I don't say I'm unsatisfied. Oh, so the attitude make different. What I'm saying is, attitude make different. You know, your attitude, you know, in order to you say I'm satisfied, you should have certain motivation, isn't it? Why you say I am satisfied. Buddhism knows each, you know, the movement or action or body speech behind something pulse. You know. So why don't you say I am satisfied? What is the cause? What is the karma? What is the causation? No, wrong attitude. You know, that wrong attitude. Wrong attitude makes you impossible. I am satisfied. So we say, check out what kind of wrong motivation. You know, the satisfy has it. You can be two things: physical satisfy and the mental satisfy. I'm talking about mental satisfy. Not only physical sensation. The mental satisfy is the most important thing. The conflict, human conflict, we have problem, you know, we are conflicting, you know, two things going on inside our mind, all the time, 24 hours, two things fighting, like this, you know, two things like this, inside, two thoughts is coming, anyway, two thoughts is fighting, you understand? Because you know, dissatisfied. Become dissatisfied. There's no thought, I am satisfied. So that the thinking wrong, that the expectation from the just the worldly, you know, sensory pleasure, it makes you satisfied. It's a wrong attitude. No way. Also now, good example now. You come here listening to this Tibetan monk lecture, thinking that monk is satisfied, expecting this, you know, the Tibetan monk is satisfy me. It's wrong. I cannot make satisfy you. No way. No way. Good example right now here. Yeah. No, the true sense, the satisfaction comes from with your own knowledge. With your own knowledge, it understands true nature of your own reality. The truth, discovering truth change your life. Discovering truth change your motivation. Discovering truth make you change your action from negative to positive. People did wrong action, wrong thinking is, you know, lack of wisdom, no understanding. You know, it's not something they do. They don't understand. Truth tell you, you know, what is best. That's why Four Noble Truth, isn't it? Shakyamuni, first time he gives Four Noble Truth. You know, looks like maybe West point of view is something special, isn't it? Four Noble Truth is something special. Truth. You know, West point of view, truth is something somewhere special, you know. Four Noble Truth is just samsara truth, isn't it? Truth of samsara, existence, isn't it? Nothing special. Truth of your body, truth of your sensation, truth of your garbage mind, truth of your positive mind, truth of these things, you know. That is truth, you know. Nothing special truth, but you know, just truth is way existent, yourself and other phenomena. Now, human quality, you know, reason why positive, we can make ourselves completely satisfied, you know, everlastingly satisfied, everlastingly peaceful, you know, everlastingly joyful, and we can achieve Such universal compassion. We can, eliminate selfish attitude, grasping attitude, and hatred attitude. We can eliminate. So, for this reason, human being is the most precious thing, most powerful, the object, okay? We have something like, new moon, when we say we like full moon, if you like full moon, you should love new moon. Communicate one, no? You know what I mean, you love Buddha. Buddha is this, Buddha is that, Buddha is fantastic. Buddha is fantastic, isn't it? He has incredible, achievement, universal compassion, universal love, and, egotistic, it is beyond egotistic, beyond dualistic fight, and, complete peace. We talk about the Buddhist knowledge, then we don't understand that all of us is the, Buddha nature. Buddha nature. We talk about Shakyamuni Buddha. Let's say Shakyamuni Buddha. Shakyamuni Buddha also, he was same thing as a confused us and dissatisfied, even though he has 100 wives and he's so rich, but he's still dissatisfied. Remember this? He's sure I'm dissatisfied. So he left his home. Same as, that from the dissatisfied, you can work out yourself and change such a way, transform in such a way, and we can achieve exactly as quality of Buddha. So we should understand each other this way and respect each other this way. We don't need other reason to respect human being each other. Maybe you people think that is a difficult one, to changing human, the mind such a way is difficult. It is not difficult one. Because all of us, we do have experience of, mind clear and happy. And we do have experience mind unclear and confused and miserable. We all have already experienced. You ask yourself, why I experience this one? What is the cause? Now, which thing is important? What is the cause to experience this truth? It's not something accidentally happened. The thinking wrong. Sometimes Western mind thinking this way, that everything you experience is just habit, just habit. No reason, just habit. That's wrong. That's wrong. Wrong thinking. It's beyond, scientific reality. Reality, all existence physically or mentally or whatever is in the world existence has causation, you know, cause, you know, cooperative cause, you know, to be existent. So that every experience within you, entire your world, since you born up till now, everything has a reason. Everything has a reason. No, don't think just happened wrong. That's definitely wrong. So this reason develops such a way, and then, you know, experience comes. Without it, you know, without reasoning, without evolution, there's no, you know, human experience. Even Western, you know, psychology, they try, they say, isn't it? Nowadays, they say, you have this problem because blah, 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 before you did this, because your father, mother, because your wife, blah, 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 blah. They try, you know, isn't it? They do, you know, they do try. But the Buddhism, you seek, you dissatisfied because your father, your mother, no. You understand? Doesn't matter your father beat your mother, beat, you know, okay? And lead you miserable, but still your miserable is something you have nuclear, some kind of, you know, attracted, you know, energy within you, you know? You know what I mean, you know? To beat your parents or something. We believe, Buddhism, you have the magnetic energy to attract bad experience, good experience, miserable, this thing. So this is very important to look at. However, simply that the wrong thinking is the, you know, the causation. Wrong thinking is the causation. That's all. You can say Buddhist point of view, the principle world, miserable principle again, principle, you know, creation of, you know, Christian, we have creation of God, isn't it? Buddhism, you can say the creation of the miserable entire world, you know, universal miserable, you know, personal miserable, all to come from the fall. The wrong thought, especially. All the pleasure you experience is the right thought. Right thought. However, thought is the, you know, principle, you know, the creation. Entire movement of, you know, bad, you know, you understand what I mean, you know? Miserable or temporary good one, temporary bad one, all this is come from the thought manifestation. So for that reason, you know, the thought has two things explained, negative thought, positive thought. The positive thought, what you, you know, sort of generate is the, you know, the antidote to the negative thought. But of course, sometimes, you know, the overwhelming of the negative thought and the antidote, positive, is sort of, you know, weak. Time being, you know, there's nothing you can do. Nothing you can do, let go. It's like middle of, you know, ocean, you know, middle of ocean. Unbelievable, you know, the tornado of traveling comes. You just let go, isn't it? What you can do? That time, what you can do? Huh? You know, even though you have this, you know, kind of, you know, you understand? But this power is weak, isn't it? The external power is so, you know, overwhelming, you know, that it's let go. Oh. But then, let go, all negative is let go? No. The tornado of the turbulence is not permanent, isn't it? You know? It is permanent, okay, then just let go, you know, then also good things happen, isn't it? It is the impermanent, therefore, somehow he stopped, he exhausted its own energy, because it has certain energy built up, isn't it? So that when the energy shaking, energy disappears, isn't it? You know? So then, again, okay, positive energy, you can utilize, and, you know, sort of, you know, previous disaster experience, you can vanish. Maybe you can call, you purify, isn't it? You heard Buddhism, you heard purify, isn't it? Purification, isn't it? It means, actually, you know, you see, that's the problem, or this reason I'm saying is, you know, how much I try to do, you know, meditate, I try to meditate, I try to keep morality and ethics and concentration, I still, you know, sometimes overwhelming negativity thought. I cannot do anything. That time, instead of you so worrying, that time you let go. Let go. You just know situation, you know. It's just you can't do that time. Let go negative way. Until, you know, it won't come down. You know. Then, you know, okay. You can again. Oh, that fearful experience, you can, you know, sort of, purify. In other words, eliminate, I can overcome strong, you know, positive, you know, you know, motivation and the action. That is the power of human skill. And if you put wrong way, wrong time, wrong thinking, hey, disaster. You put yourself situation difficult. So the real, you know, the path to liberation is just put skill. Just put skill, you know, in a deal situation, which is the best way you can do. And if you cannot do, just let go again. Then I can deal such a way. Then I can let go. So this need, you know, This comes from your own wisdom, you know. But we do believe, you do, all of us, we do have some extent of wisdom, but, you know, limitation. So we need to develop. I'm sure you heard that Buddhism three things emphasizes those who are seeking liberation, and one is morality, one is, you know, what to say. Concentration, one is wisdom. So these three is we do need in our life. Okay. The reason why we need, you know, Buddhism, morality, ethics, you can't, you know, we say we are a precious human being. How can you burn ourselves? You can communicate all, you know. We say our precious human being is something very precious. You cannot put into the fire ourselves, isn't it? You can protect it. You have to protect it from the dangerous. Yeah? You know? Destroy your entire quality, isn't it? So karma is that or that way. You know, morality is that way. You should not destroy your quality of life. Somehow you keep your mental or body, speech, mind into clean, clear situation. That is we call ethics. Not be confused. Oh, normally we confuse, isn't it? We don't understand. We don't understand really, the dealing our life with the confused situation. We don't understand how to deal. So each time we contact in the world, turn out disaster, isn't it? Because we don't know how to deal. So that you have to have wisdom dealing such, relationship in the world brings you dignity or goodness or pleasure or, and the disaster or the satisfaction. You should know and discriminate. So you put right channel, entire your life, energy, rather than making disaster situation or mental disorder situation. We do make our life, we put ourselves situation disorder. The result is effectively miserable, isn't it? Confused. So we have to have, that's why I say we do have power to choose our life such way that it's beauty of the mind. Don't put yourself, disaster. What reason I'm saying, the moral ethics. Moral ethics is sometimes Western point of view is something, you super, believing. Not like that. I'm talking about scientifically. That I don't want to talk about, such terms, this, that. I believe you understand, all of you understand. You are sense enough, intelligent enough. What I say, growth, you can pick up. That's what I'm saying. Morality is not something you believe because religion. No. You understand? Ethic is not something you believe because Buddhist religion, because Christian religion. No. Something you know. You know with your own experience. If I act motivation this way, acting this way, and this way, and going this way, lead me miserable. You know. That should avoid. I don't know what you think in that one. I don't care what accent. That you know. So the good thing, put it in, so simple. Individually, it won't understand one's own mind, dealing with one's world, and which is the best way for you, which is, that's good enough. So that is the, humanistic, and that is, human ethics, or, I don't know, earth ethics, I don't know, universal ethics, I don't know, whatever you call. So important to have such thing. Otherwise we confuse relatively, forget about absolutely. Relatively we confuse, So then we talk about the second one, concentration. Concentration we need because we have to understand true nature of existence, oneself, one's one mind, and the existence of relating external world. We have to understand this truth. In order to understand this truth, we have to have concentration. We have to have penetration. Otherwise, we're so distracted. We're so superficial. We are so busy with just the superficial, reality. We don't understand the real true nature, deepest nature of existence, we don't understand. Oh, so that we definitely need our confrontation. We are so gross. We're so gross. We don't understand refined nature of oneself. Profound nature of oneself, we don't understand. So we do need penetrated, concentration. And we do need wisdom. Again, same thing. We have so gross understanding of reality. We don't understand universal, reality or ultimate reality. We don't understand. So we do need tremendous wisdom. You do know. Just look at presence of your own mind. How the wrong view and the wrong projection. The present time you look at and you can experience. So the almost confessional, our mind is the obstacle. Rather than helpful, to understand better true nature, It is, becomes obstacle, The optical, is produced optical, illusion, So, we have to go beyond, the gross mind, So we have to seek wisdom. We have to utilize such wisdom. Which is existent within us. Existent within us. Don't need to seek outside. That the beauty of Buddhism explains the good quality. God's mind is within you. You don't need to cold mind outside. So you see, the tranquility peace. It exists within us. In other words, full moon is existed within us. Now, we're looking full moon outside. Say, when full moon coming? One could be happy. But full moon is always, shining within us. It's true. I'm just using, example. My main point is tranquility, peaceful. The quality is existent right now. Matter if you look at. Same thing. Normally, when we have depressed, we have no desire to look at full moon, isn't it? Even that time, not new moon, even, No comprehension of new moon, no comprehension of, full moon. So the same thing. It's something I tell you. Human being is so intelligent. We can find our, most profound quality is within us. 24 hours. Permanently, we can find within oneself. Oh, this is the beauty of, you know, a human being. So we should have, you know, certified just human being is, you know, something really you have, you know, more than entire universal material. So to utilize this one is so important. And then maybe you can say, how to utilize this one, you know? How to utilize, yeah. Maybe you can say, yeah, it is really something, you know, useful, the most precious thing. How to utilize? Yeah. How to utilize, you know, how to utilize. Now, and this is the, you know, to how to utilize. To increasing wisdom, you know, to clarify your own nature. I think that's good enough, you know. So what method you use, up to you. You know what I mean, you know? I'm not saying this method you use, you know. What, there's so many methods you can use. However, principle is, to make understanding. Such profound nature of your own. So my understanding is, this wisdom, better understanding of your own, you know, profound quality is the elevator. This, you know, the method to lift up, you know, the whatever your achievement. Or liberation, or whatever you want to achieve. That wisdom is the, you know, liberator. That wisdom is the, you can call teacher. That wisdom is the, you know, or your own Buddha, or Dharma, or whatever you call. Whatever you call level. So by understanding, you know, by gaining such wisdom, you can develop the confidence of yourself. The confidence of yourself. We have no confidence ourselves because we have very little knowledge. We have very little experience, isn't it? We are like baby, we shake it. So that when we have experience, better understanding, then they develop confidence. The same thing like job, you know. When you have understand some training job and you have experience, then you have confidence. It is similar internal working, you know, job, you know. Somehow, if you, you know, continuously invest it, and practicing, meditation, whatever you do, somehow you have experience. Because you act. You don't act, you have no experience. All right. That's all. You know. The thing is, simple thing, put it in. You act, you resolve. You act. Okay. You don't worry. My lifetime I act. Result is only death and death and coming. Wrong thinking. Oh. Karma is the morning you do something right thing, you know, afternoon you easy going. That is the, you know, the karma. That is the karma. I think, that's good. Now, really time to stop or no? 5 minutes, okay, good. 5 minutes more job, yes. Okay, all right. However, you know, conclusion is that the just existence or human being isn't, you know, or human quality is not human problem. You know, the superficial, the mind, which we call ego, that is the human problem, which produce the wave of grasping mind. You know, ego. You know, the mind produce. You know, like ocean, right? Yeah, ocean wave, you know, is produced grasping. It's produced, you know, all the hatred, you know, which produced, you know, all the projection, you know, unrealistic projection, so produce ignorance. So the ego is the ego mind is the biggest problem. The resource of all human symptoms. So you can see in this world nowadays, so much problem, you know. All the bloating and yonton and each nation, we are fighting each other. So many things going on, you know. Now, it's really good thing in this modern world, you know. We all understand what's going on in the world. Somehow, we are lucky, you know. Now that we understand better each other, you know, than ever. I think so. And we can see what's going on in the entire world right now. We are so lucky. If you one suspect, we are lucky. Somehow we have enlightened experience of universal what's going on. You know, you understand? You know, so that's good thing. All these things you just look at. This is the manifestation of ego, of the ego mind. each of us, we do have, you know, access and the capacity to eliminate, you know, this, you know, the big web of ocean of ego. We do have, you know, Oh. So that the also that we you know are having the tremendous expectation, you know, build up all the human relationship or individual or universal or whatever, you know, all these expectations are the, you know, are the manifestation of ego. So therefore, we should, you know, eliminate. We have power, we can do it. So that without ego reacting, the bad, good or expectation, you know, we can live. We can you know, our mind live without, you know, artificial, you know, the imitation, you know. That all these ego, you know, the expectation is like imitation, you know. Artificial, you know, imitation. The mind living as a natural state is the true. So we do have, you know, skill to live mind as neutralized. Live as neutralized without the artificial and the level, you know. It's possible without reacting, you know, the expectation, good and bad. The nature of the mind is clear, you know, the mirror, in order to take a reflection of phenomena. So the moment we go in meditate, you don't think about it. You are meditator, or you don't think about it. You know, what is the object of meditation? The moment you just live, just mind just live as it is. Whatever there, if there, negative there, positive there, you don't discriminate, just leave there. Whether negative or positive, it is still clear, the reflection. The beauty of mind, whether negative or positive, they essentially, it is so clear nature. Because in order to take the reflection, a phenomenon. So, now, moment before we break, you know, we please all of us, you know, meditate. don't think you have to meditate, you know. Don't think you have to meditate, you know. You just be. Just be, you know. Whatever right moment you experience is there in your mind, that all, you know. Not the object of, you know, existence, just the subject state of your mind. Whatever the moment is there, just let go. The beauty of that state, doesn't matter what state, it's clean, clear. You just leave. No expectation, good happening, bad happening, just leave. Thank you. just be. Without artificial level of expectation, good and bad. So the mind should be protected from the destructive thought of sensory object. Only contemplate or let go the subject of clarity experience. Also, the thought itself has character to barbed certain color. While you are concentrated on the clarity of your own mind, if color manifests, don't try to stop color. Also, color is vibration. It's like sun. Before the sun, the light shining, there's some vibration, similar. Without good bad thought reacting, just stay the being clarity of your own mind. As much as you could. Even though thought process is changing, the essential clarity is always there. So you don't move from the clarity. You stay into the clarity. Reflecting vibration of color, just aware, but don't pay attention, don't react, just aware, just leave as it is, don't make conversation. The nuclear of human being is the thought or memory or consciousness. However, its nature is always clarity, clear nature. Thank you. with a comprehension, our own thought nature is so sensible, so scientific. So realistic. We all become enlightened. all right. Thank you. Okay. Dedication is a part of the Buddhist practicing. It's not something ritual, you know, customatic. It is a profound psychological explanation. However, this way, that we have some kind of experience with our own ethnic meditation, if we have some kind of peaceful, you know, better understanding, some kind of energy, positive energy. We share all this energy, those who need, of the all universal living being. As you know, so many living beings are even relatively suffering, and the bloodying, and the killing, and those are, Buddhist point of view, consider our mother, our father. Okay? Poland people are our mother, our father, and the Israel people are our mother, our father, Lebanese people are our mother, our father, you know, as a mommy totally we are a little bit different, but we give energy to those who really need it, you know, and dedicate. So what happened is not something you just, you know, dreaming, you know, because sometimes we have ego, react again. Oh, fantastic. I have this, I have this. Again, you know, we produce reaction of karma, negativity, you know, superstition. So this is the point. In order to eliminate ego pride, you know, reaction, we dedicate it. So it's no longer pride object. So it's very useful. Dedication is very useful. Especially, it put it play or is needed rather than flooded, you know, waste of energy. So you put direct, you know, with the aim, motivation, then also you put right place rather than wrong place. Okay, so it is useful. I don't know what I'm saying again. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. Next week we have meditation session or no? All right, then meditation should be this one. Okay, today. More emphasis, that area. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Another day.